We have this question right here. It's asking, let S is equal to x1, x2 in R2, 2x1 equal to x2, is S a subspace of R2? Justify your answer. And the same kind of question in the second question. So let's begin with the first one. So let's see. So in this case, first of all, in order to prove something in a subspace, we have to have three conditions. The first condition should be, it should have a zero element. Right? Zero element. That's the first condition. The second condition, it should be closed under addition. Closed under addition. And the third one is, it should be closed under scalar multiplication. Closed under scalar multiplication. Right, these are the three things we have to look for when they ask if this is in a subspace of R2. So let's see, is this fulfills this one. So first of all, if it has zero element, I have to, what do I have to do is, if I put zero for x1 and x2, what's the value I get? So first of all, if I put zero for this one, 2 times 0 is equal to x2 0. So this is going to be 0 0. Since we have 0 0, we have zero element. We have fulfilled the first condition. So let's move to the second condition. The second condition is, it should be closed under addition. And they have given x1 and x2. So let's say, if this is, so they are saying if a system has x1 and x2, the 2 times x1 should be equal to x2. So in this case, if this is true, if we take, for example, I'm saying AB belongs to the set. So if this is true, this should be true. Like if I take AB in a subspace, 2 times of A should be equal to B. So this is I'm doing based on this. So let's to take another value. For example, I take let's say I can take x1 and x2 directly, right? X1 and x2 belongs to S, and if I take this one, it should be, then it should be 2x1 is equal to x2. That's what they are given. So in this case, so if this is true, if I let's say we have AB, right? If I add both of them, AB x1 x2, if this is true, if I add both of them, what I get? I will get A plus x1 B plus x2. So this is in the system. Then if these two are true, then this should be true, like the first multiplication of first value by twice. So 2 times A plus x1 should be equal to B plus x2. So that's what we have to prove. So first of all, let's say, let's bring everything to the other side. So it's, let's say 2A minus B is equal to 0. Then 2x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. Then if I take this one to the other side, it's going to be 2a plus 2x1 minus b minus x2 is equal to 0. So if I take 2 common here, it's going to be 2 times, I can switch this one, 2a minus b minus b plus 2x1 minus x2. I can add this, I can write this equation as this one, 2a minus b plus 2x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. Since if you look at this equation, this is the same value as here, 2a minus b is equal to 0. So I can substitute this value here, it's going to 0. Then if I substitute this value here, it's plus 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, we have proved this is closed under addition. So it has fulfilled the second condition. It's closed under addition. Now let's move to the third one. The third one is saying it should be closed under scalar multiplication. Let's see how we can prove this. So first of all, let's say I'm taking alpha as a scalar. So alpha belongs to this subspace. So if I take alpha into scalar, So for example, also I am taking AB in the subspace, AB in the set. If AB in the set, we know according to this equation 2A, like the first value. If AB is AB, the A is first value, right? So 2A should be equal to B. 2A should be equal to B. Then we know, like, we can rearrange this equation. So let's say 2A minus B is equal to 0. If I rearrange this equation, then if this is true, if I multiply this AB by alpha, alpha A times B, so it's going to become what? Alpha A, alpha B, right? Alpha A, comma alpha B. Then what's going to happen is, if this is true, then this would be true to alpha A, my 2 alpha A minus alpha B should be equal to 0. So let's see how we can prove this one. So in this case, we have this one. So if I multiply this equation by alpha, alpha times 2, oh, I can do this here. So it's, if I take take alpha common, then it's going to be 2a minus b equal to 0. Alpha, then 2a minus b, we know it's already 0. So if I plug this 0 right here, is equal to 0, therefore we know this is 0. Therefore we know this is closed under scalar multiplication. Scalar multiplication, right? So since this is true, we have fulfilled all three conditions. Therefore the answer is, they are asking, is S a subspace of R2? Yes, of course it's a subspace of R2, because it has zero element, it is closed under addition, and it's closed under scalar multiplication. Therefore this is of course a subspace of R2. This is how we prove this question. The second question is asking, let S2 is equal to X1, X2 in R2, X2 is equal to 1, is S the first subspace of R2? Justify your answer. So this is answer for the first question, A. Let's do the B question. So if I move to the B question, the first thing is it should have a zero element. Let's check it. Before I move to the other one, let's check it. So in this case, X2 should be equal to 1. So what happened if you put 0 for X2? 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, this system doesn't have a zero element, because 0 is equal to 1. Then it doesn't have a zero element at all, because this is not possible. Therefore, this is failing the first condition. Therefore, we can say this is not a subspace of R2. So that's how we prove this question. So the answer for the first question is yes, it's a subspace of R2. But the answer for the second question is no, it's not a subspace of R2, because it doesn't have a zero element. Also, you can check other things like closed under addition, closed under scalar multiplication. It gives you the same answer. But this is the easiest method. If one condition is failed, then everything, like, you don't have to go further step, go for other steps. So that's how we prove this question. I hope you guys like this video. See you next time.